Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I was inspired by prom. Hopefully you learned something from today's video. Like and subscribe, click that notification bell, and let's get started. I'm going to begin with my hair parted on the right side. Then I'm going to divide out a section of hair on the left side of my head from the part down to my left ear. I'm going to clip this hair aside to use for the braid later on. Now I'm going to pin the crown section. So I'm going to divide off a section of hair from the sides of my head going back towards the back of my head. I'm going to slightly twist this hair towards the left side and then pin it in place using a couple bobby pins. Then I'm going to go back over the section and gently pinch and pull on small pieces of hair to loosen them and create some volume and dimension in the crown section. Next, I'm going to create the bun portion of the hairstyle. So I'm first dividing out a few pieces of hair to frame my face on the right side. And then I'm going to combine the remaining hair together at the nape of my neck. Using a hairband, I'm going to tie the hair together into a ponytail. Once it's tied off, I'm going to create a rope braid with my ponytail to use for the bun. So I'm going to divide the ponytail into two equal sections, and I'm going to cross the left section over the right while also twisting the two sections towards the left side. Once all of the ponytail is twisted, I'm going to wrap the twist clockwise around the base of the ponytail so it creates a bun. Then using bobby pins, I'm going to slide these into the hair so it secures the twist against my head. I like to slide the pins in towards the center of the bun so they stay hidden under the hair, and I put one in wherever I'm holding the hair with my fingers. So I just work my way around the bun, pinning it wherever it feels loose. Then with the ends, I'm going to tie an elastic band over these to keep them combined together, and then I'm going to tuck them under the bun and pin them in place using another bobby pin. Now I'm going to create the braid portion of the style. I'm going to let down the hair on the left side of my head and divide off a small section near the part to begin my braid. I'm creating a fishtail braid, so I'm going to start the braid like a regular three-strand braid by crossing the two side strands once over the middle strand. Then I'm going to combine two of the strands together, and this will switch it to a fishtail style braid. So I'm taking small pieces from one side and crossing them over, combining them into the opposite side section. I'm also going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the bottom side of the braid to create a lace style braid. This type of braid will give the hairstyle an overall softer look. So I'm still crossing small sections of hair from one side over to the opposite side while also picking up new sections of hair from underneath the bottom of the braid and crossing these over the top, adding them into the top or right side section of the braid. And I'm going to create the braid along the left side of my head. And as I'm braiding, I'm also going to make sure to leave out small sections of hair along the hairline just to help frame my face once the style is done. So I'm continuing the lace style fishtail braid, working my way along the left side of my head until I've brought in all of the hair that I want to on this side. Once that's done, I'm going to continue braiding the fishtail braid a little further down. So I'm crossing small sections of hair from one side over to the opposite side to ensure the braid will reach around to the back of my head so I can pin it above the bun at the back. Once the braid reaches far enough, I am going to bring it around the back of my head and lay it above the top of the bun. Then I'm going to fold it under and pin it in place using bobby pins. I like to pin the braid from the right side, and I also make sure to slide them underneath the hair so they don't stick out and show. Then once it's all pinned, I can go back over the braid and gently pull on the edges to make the braid look a little bit wider so it's easier to see.
And I'm also going to make sure to pin down any ends that are sticking out with some bobby pins.
That wraps up today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe. Click that notification bell as well so you never miss any future uploads. And I will see you next time.